In the following tutorial, we're going to go over printing and exporting. Now, I can either print directly from Stonecut, or I can transfer the image to an external program like Adobe Illustrator, CorelDRAW. Let me show you the easy way to transfer this image back to CorelDRAW. The easiest way to do it is to select it, hit Control-C on your keyboard, go ahead and open up CorelDRAW, right mouse click, and hit paste. Here you go. So we're just copying and pasting back to CorelDRAW. Now, once we have this image into CorelDRAW, what we can do is we can export this as a PDF file. So what I'll do is I'll go to File. Instead of going to the Export function, I'll go to Publish to PDF. I'll select my settings. We're going to go ahead and put this on my desktop. And then we'll just call this Sample. We'll select our settings. In this case, we're going to go over here and do a preset for PDF for editing. And that's going to go ahead and preserve all of the original quality of the original PDF file. Now, if we want to password protect this, what I can do is go ahead and select Settings, go over here to Security. I can put a permission password in here. I can also put a printing password in here. I can restrict editing. So if I went down here and said no editing, I'll give you permission to print that at low resolution. We can put a password in here. I'll just type in DAS. DAS, there we go. Over here, we can just go ahead and click on OK to accept those changes. We're going to have our file is already named. We're going to put it on the desktop, and we'll just click on Save. So we've created that PDF. Once the PDF is created, anyone with Adobe Acrobat Reader can just go and open it. So we'll just double click on it right here. It's going to open that file up into Adobe Acrobat. And that particular file is 1.9 megabytes. And you'll notice it's redrawing there on the screen because that's the original vector artwork. So you get a very high quality proof. Now the other option, we could also export this directly from Stonecut in a variety of formats. If we wanted to bring it over to Adobe Illustrator, probably the easiest way to do that is export it as an EPS file. You can also export that as a JPEG file. So we'll go over here and export the file. And that export means that we're not saving it in the original job format. We're converting it to another format. So what we'll do is we'll go over here and we'll say sample JPEG. And then we'll select our options. So we have it named. We're going to put it on the desktop. We'll go ahead and click on save. We're going to go ahead and move this slider depending upon the quality. So I can make this file smaller or larger. We're going to go ahead and use best quality. We'll click on OK. And then we're creating a JPEG proof. Now this JPEG is no longer vector artwork. So because it's a JPEG, the client, there's no risk of the client being able to import it back into Adobe Illustrator. Still, it's a fairly high quality image. Let's go ahead and minimize this real quick. And let's see the file size. So I'm going to right mouse click on this file. We'll go to Properties. We're seeing the file size is only 200K. So it's a very small file. It's been converted to a bitmap, so there's no danger of somebody being able to take this file and output it. And then we can attach this to an email and send this over to a client. Now the next thing we're going to do is we're going to cover printing. Pretty simple. If I want to print this file, all I need to do is go to File, Print. I need to select my print driver, all my settings. So we could go over here and select the different settings for my particular printer. Just by clicking on settings, we're going to do either portrait or landscape or orientation. We can select that from the drop-down list. We're going to print all objects. We're going to center this to the center of our document. And then to print this, all I need to do is click on OK, and then we're going to print that out to our printer. And that concludes this tutorial lesson.